各位弟兄姐妹平安。
Good morning, brothers and sisters.
非常抱歉，今天我们电脑有一些网络有一些问题。
Please accept our sincere apologizing this morning. We have some serious issues with our internet.
科技给我们很多好处，但有的时候我们也是靠着科技就会有这些问题出现。
We thank God for technology, but sometimes technology also bring with it its own problems.
所以今天我们无法实况转播，我们用录影的方式。
So this morning we're not able to live stream. We will be recording and broadcasting it later on.
但是我们欢迎在场的弟兄姐妹。
But we want to welcome all the brothers and sisters who are with us right now.
我们就开始今天的敬拜。
Let's start today's worship.
I sing for all that
kind of service.
Trophies down, all down, Jesus' feet.
我们谢谢英文崇拜带给我们的诗歌。
We thank God for the English worship teams for their leading of worship.
我们现在一起做个祷告。
Let's pray together.
亲爱的主，我们人生有很多的意外。
Our Heavenly Father, we come before you.
我们人生有很多的意外。
Oh, we have, there are a lot of things in our lives that are outside our control.
今天早上我们就是在这样的情况中来敬拜你。
And with circumstances outside our control, today we come to worship you.
求你给我们一颗平安的心。
Lord, please give us peaceful hearts.
也求你给在家里的弟兄姐妹一个平安的心，等候录影。
Father, we also just pray for the brothers and sisters at home. Please give them a peaceful heart as well.
求你帮助我们今天早上再次思想你话语的时候，让我们知道我们如何拥有一个健康的财富观念。
And Lord, we just pray that as we continue our worship, that you would give us today a healthy view of our finances, of our stewardship, of our possessions.
我们将祷告，奉主耶稣的圣名祈求。
We pray these things in the precious name of our Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
好，我们今天是联合崇拜。
Today is our combined worship.
那我们每联合崇拜都是讲丛松谦的这本书的主题。
And so for our combined worship, we are talking about themes from this book.
那我们首先讲到了基础根基。
So we've been building this up. You might recall we started with the roots and the foundations.
我们的基础是休息、祷告、读经。
And our the foundation is Sabbath, prayer, and sacred reading.
然后在这个基础上，我们建立一个健康的关系。
And based on that foundation, we actually build healthy relationships.
借着友谊，借着性，借着家庭。
And this has to do with friendship, sexuality, and family.
然后呢，让我们的生命可以重新得力。
And with that, we will be restored.
我们的身体可以重新得力。
So our bodies could be restored.
上个月我们思想到游玩。
And help us, also we saw that there's a healthy theology of play.
特别是在疫情期间，我们更是要有这样的一个健康的游玩心态，在神面前活出我们的生活。
And especially at this time with COVID-19, we really need to have a healthy perspective of play before God.
那第三个得力呢，是在金钱上重新得力。
And the third part of restoration has to do with your money, how you handle your finances.
一开始我有一点不了解我们的重新得力跟金钱有什么关系。
At first, I was kind of puzzled by the fact how this restoration has anything to do, or how this finance has anything to do with our restoration.
但是刚好我们这个这次在讲路加福音。
But as we are going through our preaching series on Luke,
我从路加福音发现到的确金钱跟我们的灵性生命的成长有很大的关系。
I saw that from Luke that there is a close connection between our view of finance, how we handle our possessions, and healthy spirituality.
所以今天我的题目呢有一点 catchy 啊。
So my title is very catchy today.
但是呢，这不是我发明的。
This is not my own invention.
这个我是借用马丁路德的话。
This is from Martin Luther.
所以呢，今天我们要看荷包的归信。
So today is called the title sermon title is called Conversion of Our Purses.
这个呢，我是看到马丁路德的一句话，他说呢，我们呢必须有三种的归信。
Martin Luther once said this. There are three conversions.We need to have three conversions. Three types of conversions.
第一个呢是心的归信。
First of all, it's a conversion of our hearts.
第二个呢是思想的归信。
The second conversion is conversion of our minds.
第三个归信是荷包的归信。
The third conversion is the conversion of our purse.
我想最容易的也不太容易，但是我们通常做的是心的归信。
In some ways, the easiest one is And something that happens the most often is the conversion of our hearts.
但是第二个，我发现对有一些科学的人呢，思想的归信有一点困难。
And the second conversion is a little bit more challenging, especially those who come from the scientific mind.
我不知道在北美的就是那个白人或者是黑人怎么样，但是至少在台湾的，在台湾教会呢，用灵异解经讲道 allegorical,
OK,
用灵异讲道最多的是学科学的人。
灵异讲道是
allegorical.
Oh, allegorical. OK, OK. I don't know about the situations here in the North America, but I can tell you in Taiwan, the ones who use allegorical interpretation of the Bible, interpretation of preaching the Bible, are those with the scientific mind.
特别是一些学科学的人。
Especially those who have a background in science.
他们学科学，但是呢，他们读圣经的时候呢，似乎把那些科学都忘在脑子后面了。
And because even though they have this very scientific mind, when it comes to their approach to the scripture, they kind of really put their scientific mind and just turn off their scientific mind.
照理来说呢，寓意解经应该是他们最不会选择的。
And in fact, you know, exegesis should be something that someone with a scientific mind should be most readily to accept.
但是他们竟然用 allegorical 来解释圣经，他们不觉得有问题，也就是他们的思想还没有好好的归信。
And so, but they, those scientific mind oftentimes use allegorical interpretation of the Bible because this really shows that their mind has not been changed by the scripture.
第三个是荷包的归信。
The third conversion we're talking about is the conversion of the purse.
那斯布珍讲过一句话。
Spurgeon once said this.
他说对有些人最难以成圣的是他们的口袋。
With some, the last part of their nature that ever gets sanctified is their pockets.
成圣其实它的意思就是分别出来。
The idea of the word sanctification is the idea, has the idea of being separated out.
所以呢，在我们斯布珍说呢，我们的生命当中呢，最难以分别为圣的就是我们的口袋。
And so what Spurgeon really says is the last part of us to be separated out from this world is in fact our pocketbook.
所以的确，后来我从路加福音来看，金钱是我们灵性成长的拦阻。
So I see that from Luke's gospel, money, finance, possession is one of the hardest strongholds.To barrier, biggest barrier to our spiritual growth.
在耶稣讲撒种的比喻，其中有一个字，我们有的时候没有好好的注意到。
And you know, when in Jesus' parable of the sower, there's one word oftentimes we fail to translate correctly.
下一张 slides. 再来。就是呢，在撒种的比喻呢，耶稣说呢，其中有一种种子呢，它是落在荆棘里的，听了道走开以后，被今生的思虑、钱财、宴乐挤住了，便结不出成熟的籽粒来。
Luke 8:14, Jesus says this, and as for what fell among the thorns, there are those who hear, but as they go on their way, they are choked by the cares and riches and pleasures of life, and their fruit does not mature.
所以我们基督徒在我们的灵性生活当中有很多的阻拦，其中一个阻拦就是金钱。
And so in our Christian lives, in our Christian growth, there are lots of barriers to our spiritual growth, and one of the biggest areas is finance.
那这个比喻在很多的福类福音中都有提到。
Parable is actually mentioned many times in all the synoptic gospels.
但是呢，路加福音呢，它呢，特别是从旅行叙事第九章开始到十九章这个 travel narrative 里面呢，它有很多讨论到财富。
But especially this is an emphasis, especially in the Gospel of Luke, especially from Luke 9:19, where it's called a traveling narrative, to heading to Jerusalem. There's lots of mention by Jesus of our right view, Christian view to money.
在路加福音十二章十三节到三十四节，它有一段很长的一个段落，讲到我们如何拥有一个健康的财富观。
In Luke chapter 12, 13 to 34, there's a long section of what it means to have a healthy view of wealth and money.
然后在路加福音十六章十三节，路加或者是福利福音的作者，他们把金钱跟偶像同等。
In Luke chapter 16, 13, Luke made a comparison between money and idolatry.
在十六章十九节到三十一节，有一个只有他写过的比喻，就是财主跟拉撒路。
And there's Luke chapter 16, 19 to 31, there's a parable that's only found in Luke, and which is the parable of the rich man and Lazarus.
然后在路加福音十八章十八节到二十九节讲到那个官来见耶稣。
And Luke 18:18 to 29, there's the story of the rich man who came to see Jesus.
在马可福音说他很年轻。
Mark's Gospel, it says that this man was a young man, rich young man.
总而言之呢，他是因为金钱的关系呢，他忧忧愁愁的离开，没有办法接受天国。
Whatever his background is, we all know the story is that he departed from Jesus sadly, in despondency, because he could not part with his wealth.
然后在二十一章一到四节，路加提到两种奉献。
In Luke chapter 21, 1 to 4, Luke mentioned two types of offering.
因为这些在以后的讲道中我们都会提，所以呢，我就不会讲这些经文。
Because we will be coming to these passages later on, our preacher and gospel, so I will not mention that right now.
所以呢，但是我就是跟各位提到，路加呢，他是福利福音作者里面讲财富讲的最多的一位作者。
Just want to mention that of all the gospel writers,Luke is the one who mentioned the most about the Christian view to money.
然后在十六章十四节，当耶稣讲完说我们不能侍奉主又侍奉马门的时候呢，路加福音讲了这么样的一句话，说法利赛人是贪爱钱财的。
In Luke chapter 16:13, right after Jesus said that you cannot serve both God and mammon, right after that in verse 14.Luke mentions that the Pharisees were lovers of money.
然后这个字呢，其实在希腊文就是一个字。
But this lovers of money in Greek is actually one word.
这个字呢，在提摩太后书三章二节又出现。
And this word shows up again in 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 2.
然后呢，这个字呢，保罗说，末世有很多的征兆，我们通常都会喜欢看耶稣讲的。但是保罗在提摩太后书三章也讲到一些末世的征兆，其中一个就是贪爱钱财。
In 2 Timothy 3:2, he talks about the last days, what happened in the end times. Oftentimes, we look at what Jesus says about the last days, but the Apostle Paul also mentioned about the last days, and one of the signs of last days is that people will be lovers of money.
这个贪爱钱财就出现这两次。
So this word.That's used for lover of money shows up these two times.
然后这个名词呢，出现在提摩太前书六章十节，中文译的比较这个直接一点。他说：“贪财是万恶之根。”
So this word, the noun phrase, shows up one other time. It's in 1 Timothy 6:10, and the Chinese translate more.
贪心。
more literal, more harder, meaning basically greedy.
但是其实我觉得英文的翻译更好。
But I actually like the English translation.
其实它这个原来的希腊文的字根是爱的意思，喜欢的意思。
Because the word in the Greek word is a composition of two words. In the first part is love. It just has the word love.
所以呢，当我们讲到贪心，我们只是想到负面的。但是呢，在这里呢，其实保罗讲的是说我们喜爱。
So because.Oftentimes greedy, we think of something that's just really upfront. But what Paul is talking about is the love, the motivation of our hearts.
所以你喜爱的程度关系到你属灵生命的成长。
So that really what you really love actually affects your spiritual life.
有一位在 Calvin College 教书的，好像是叫 James K. Smith， 他有一本书，题目叫做《You Are What You Love》。
There's a professor at where?
Calvin College.
Oh, Calvin College. He wrote a book called "You Are What You Love."
我们是一个什么样的人？我们喜欢什么东西？我们就是一个什么样的人。
Really, what you love, what you treasure, shows who you are.
所以这也就让我们看到 Barnard Group 去年做了一个调查，非常的有意思。
So there's a with that, I want to bring up a research that Barnard did last year that's very interesting.
我要问各位，来阿东，你觉得全美国最捐钱最多的三个城市在哪里？
If I were to ask you, what three cities, what top three cities are more, the most generous, who give the most charity, what would you say?
前三名我没有一个地方听过。
What's amazing was that the first three, the top three cities, I have never heard of these cities before.
下一个 Pocatello, Pocatello, Idaho Falls, and Jackson. 你听过吗？
没有。
OK, 三个都在 Idaho.
The top is Pocatello, Idaho Falls, and Jackson, Idaho.
下面，换句话说呢？全美国的最大的城市，包括基督徒在里面，他们没有列在前五十名。
And so what's amazing is that the top three givers, top three giving cities, three most city, charitable cities, are all in Idaho. America's largest city do not even make it to the top 50 list.
包括我们很熟悉的纽约、洛杉矶、芝加哥、休斯顿、凤凰城、费城
，including New York, Philadelphia, San Francisco, Los Angeles, or Houston didn't make it to the list.
这些地方的基督徒，他们一年给不到3308块。
Wow. So the Christians there every year do not give past $3,000.
下一张。前十名是在这些城市。
So here is a picture of the top 10.
然后我查了一下，我记得 Wisconsin 好像没有在前五十名的城市。
And in my research, I was interested. I guess Wisconsin, any of the cities in Wisconsin did not even make it to top 50.
在这里呢，我们看到呢，这些前五十名的城市呢，都是非常小的城市，收入不高的地方。
We can see that all these top 10 are small cities.
我觉得有一个原因，我猜就是因为，当我们钱越多的时候，其实我们就越变得难以慷慨。
I think one of the reasons is that there is the more money we have, we actually in fact become more stingy.
我自己也是一样。
I know that to be true about myself.
在疫情期间，亚马逊的创办人 Jeff Bezos 他捐了一大笔钱。
In during the coronavirus, Jeff Bezos, the richest man, actually gave a lot of money.
他给了1250万美金。
He donated $125 million.
但是有人指出来，其实呢，他自己的钱呢是大概1400亿。
But someone pointed out his net worth is actually $143 billion.
换句话说呢，他给的那个1250万美金呢，就算你我给的85块美金。
So what he gave is basically equivalent to about $85 for the median American donor.
所以我们呜哇1250万的时候呢，其实那个对他来讲只是个 pocket change 而已。
So when we look at this large amount, $125 million, is probably pocket change for him.
所以换句话说呢，这就是当然也有很多有钱人，他们非常的慷慨，但是的确钱财越多，我们就变得越难以慷慨。
The point is that there are a lot of wealthy people who are very generous, but what we can deduce from this is that the more money we have, is actually doesn't mean translate into the more generous we are.
所以呢，换句话说呢，在路加福音后来讲到的那个两个小钱的比喻呢，在上帝的天平上。 他的钱跟 Jeff Bezos 的$1,430 billion是一样的。
So when we comes to God's comparison, you know, we come to the story of where the poor widow gave two small coins. You know, basically what she give is considered even more than what someone like Jeff Bezos can give.
因为在马可福音12:41-44这里说，别人给的都是多出来的，但是呢，他呢是自己不足，把一切养生的都投上。
So what, look at what Jesus here said about the woman who gave the two copper coin. He says this, for they all contributed out of their abundance, but she out of her poverty has put in everything she had, all she had to live on.
再次的，我不知道在北美如何，在台湾呢，他们奉献祷告的时候呢，他们很喜欢说，主啊，求你悦纳我们奉献的两个小钱。
I don't know what it's like here in North America, but oftentimes in Taiwan, when it comes to prayer before giving, oftentimes the presider or pastor would like to say, Lord, would you please receive our two small coins?
下次你讲这句话的时候，请你小心一点。
If you want, next time when you say this phrase, please be careful.
因为耶稣的重点不在于两个小钱。
The emphasis is not on the two small coins.
重点是他把养生的钱都奉献出来了。
The point is that she even offered what she had to live on.
所以我们当中没有一个人，我们把我们养生的钱奉献在奉献袋里面。
Because I know none of us in here has ever offered our what we have to live on to God.
所以下次你祷告说求神悦纳两个小钱，你的意思是说？要把你整个的家都卖掉给耶稣。
So next time when you pray, please accept our two small coins. You're really saying, Lord, let me give up all that I have to give to you.
所以在上帝的天平里面，是你拥有多少跟你给了多少的那个 proportion。
So in God's economy is what you give based on all that you have. That's important.
所以为什么在哥林多后书8:1-4，保罗特别提到马其顿的教会做一个例子。
So this is why Paul made an example of the Macedonian church in 2 Corinthians 8.
马其顿教会他不是给了很多的钱，而是因为他们自己非常的贫穷，但是呢，保罗说他们展现出 overflowed in a wealth of generosity.
So what?Paul prays the Macedonian church is not the amount of money they give, but it is because out of their poverty they give of what they have.
然后这里特别说他们是乐捐的厚恩, a wealth of generosity.
Oh, here is especially the Apostle Paul says that in their example of poverty have overflowed in a wealth of generosity.
所以这个是保罗是上帝所称赞的。
So this is whatGod actually prays.
而且接下来说，我可以证明他们是按着力量，而且也过了力量。
In fact, Paul says, he says that I can testify and beyond their means of their own core, they give.
接下来我花一点时间讲最后这一节。
And I just want to emphasize this last part, this last phrase that Paul says here.
保罗说，马其顿的教会再三的请求我们准他们在这供给圣徒的恩情上有份。
And here it says that the Macedonian Christians beg us earnestly for the favor of taking part in the relief of the saints.
这里呢，在希腊文它有三个名词，我愿意用这个三个名词跟各位一起勉励。
And there in this clause that Paul the apostle gave.He's give three nouns, and I want to use these three nouns to give everyone encouragement.
所以呢，英文跟中文原来的翻译是这样的，下两个。但是呢，如果直接的翻译呢，英文应该是说，再下一个，请朱牧师念英文的。
Begging us earnestly for the favor.
没有，第二个。
Oh, begging us earnestly for the charity and fellowship in the service of the saints.
三个名词，恩慈、传契、服事。
So it's charity,
fellowship,
and service.
这三个在早期教会都是非常重要的。
These three words are very important key words in the early church.
其实我们的 charity 就是从 charis 这个字来的，对不对？
Right. And in fact, the word charity came from the favor or grace. The English word for charity came from this grace.
所以其实中文翻译的话呢，就是说再三再四的恳求我们，让他们以恩慈团契服侍圣徒的需要。所以弟兄姐妹，今天我们思想金钱的时候呢，我们要思想我们是不是一个有恩慈的人。
And so when we think about money today, we have to see ourselves, are we a charitable person?
第二个呢，其实金钱呢，它可以是一个团契的关系。
And second of all, finance could be something, it has something to do with fellowship.
所以这里呢，保罗用 koinonia 来形容马其顿奉献的态度。
And we all remember the word koinonia, right? It's the koinonia, it's the idea of fellowship. It's used by Paul right here for how money actually bring about fellowship.
所以借着马其顿奉献金钱给耶路撒冷的教会，这两个教会有了团契的关系。
So through the Macedonian church giving to the Jerusalem church,This means that the two churches now have fellowship with each other.
然后当我们慷慨地使用我们金钱的时候呢，其实我们也是在服侍。
And so when we're generous in giving our finance to other people, we are actually also serving others.
然后在旧约律法，我们也看到神的心意从来不是让我们的所有的东西呢只留给自己用。
And if you look at even the Old Testament laws,You could see that God has never intended that the money that we have should be used for ourselves.
在生命记十二章讲到他们进到迦南地之后呢，他们要把他们所有的祭物、所有的收成都拿到一个地方。在十二章六到七节说，跟家人一起吃。
And so here it says that when the people entered into the promised land, there was only one place.For sacrifice, and they were to bring that sacrifice, and they were to share that with their family.
在这里呢，我要跟中文的congregation澄清一件事情。
Here I want to especially clarify something with the Chinese congregation.
在上个礼拜，我在灵修视频里面讲到说，十一奉献第一次出现是在生命记十四章是不对的。
Okay, last week when I talked about in my devotion, I said that the first time Tithing appeared in the Bible is Deuteronomy 14. I'm wrong about that.
其实第一次是亚伯拉罕献给麦基洗德。
But the first time is really when Abraham gave a tenth of all he had to Melchizedek.
但是呢，我那次的意思其实是说，《生命记》是十四章是第一次谈论到十一奉献。
But what I meant to say is that Deuteronomy 14 is the first time tithing in principle is explained.
然后呢，在这里他说，你把所有的你的献祭，你收成的东西呢，你献的时候呢，在六章七节说跟你的 household， 你的家属，然后到了十二节呢，又进一步说要跟你的儿女、仆婢，并住在你城里无份无业的利未人。
And here it says that you are actually to share this tithe and to share with your family members.And to celebrate together, and also you are to share part of that to the Levites who are among you.
然后到了生命记十四章呢，又进了一步。每逢三年的时候呢，他们要把整个收成的十分之一拿出来，不仅是跟家人，不仅是跟利未人，而且这里说你要跟城里寄居的，并孤儿寡妇一起来吃。
And here it says at the end of every 3 years, not only do you celebrate with your family.Not only do you celebrate with the Levite, but you also celebrate with the sojourner, the fatherless, and the widows who are within your towns.
所以我们在这里可以看到一个 progression, 就是呢自己的家、利未人、寄居的、孤儿寡妇。
So we see a progression here between from our family to the Levites and then to the sojourner, the fatherless, and the widow.
换句话说，当以色列人进到迦南地，他们的收入越来越多，他们农产越来越多的时候呢，神希望 他们帮助的范围也会越来越多。
So in other words is that as they enter in the promised land and God prospered them, and as he prospered them more and more, he wants the parameters of who they give to expand more and more as well.
所以呢，求主帮助我们，让我们学习马其顿教会的榜样，让我们有恩慈，让我们有团契，要让我们有服事的态度来使用金钱。
And so may God help us to use the church from Macedonia to learn about charity, to learn about generosity, and to learn about fellowship and service.
下面呢，我要讲一个戒指的故事。
And next, I want to share about a story about a ring.
不是魔戒。
Oh, it's not the Lord of the Ring. Ring.
我在神学院念书的时候呢，我有一个同学是马来西亚来的，他是个孤儿。
When I was studying seminary, I had a friend who was from Malaysia, and he was an orphan.
他非常的穷。
He was very poor.
但是呢，那年呢，他准备要结婚了。
But that year he was getting ready to get married.
有一天，他的女，我们刚好是在同一个祷告小组里面。
We happened to be in the same prayer group.
所以呢，他的女朋友就在讲说，我们两个人都非常的穷，我们准备结婚，我们不晓得要从哪里开始。
So on one day for prayer meeting, his fiance sure, you know, we're both very poor, but we want to get married and we don't know where to start.
他说我非常担心我们这些钱哪里来。
So we're very worried about where the money's going to come from.
然后那天我回到我的 dorm 之后呢。
So, and that day, when I returned to my dorm,
我就看着我自己手上的戒指。
I saw a ring on my finger.
我那个戒指呢，是我大学毕业的时候我妈妈送给我的。
That ring was given to me by my mother when I graduated from college.
其实那个时候我爸爸失业。He's out of job. He was out of job.
At the time when my mom purchased that for me, my dad was unemployed, lost his job.
我不知道他从哪来的钱帮我买的这个戒指。
I don't know where she got the money to buy this ring for me.
所以呢，我就决定把它戴在我的手上。
So I just decided to wear this ring on me.
其实他还帮我买了一个金链子。
And she, in fact, she actually also bought me a golden gold chain.
但是我想保住我的脖子，所以我没有戴过。
But I wanted to protect my neck, so I never wore it.
所以呢，我那天呢，我看着我自己的这个戒指呢，我看一下，这个戒指比通常的戒指要大一点。
And I saw that the ring that I was wearing was a little slightly bigger than the ring that most people have.
所以我就把我那个朋友找来。
So I took my friend. I brought my friend over.
我说这样吧，我说你就用我的这个戒指，然后呢去买你的结婚戒指吧。
And I said, you know what? Just take my ring, and with my ring, buy yourself a wedding ring.
然后呢，他拿了那个戒指去量了，那个戒指它是7.5公克。
And that ring is 7.5 grams.
7.5 grams.
7.5 grams.
一般的结婚戒指大概是3.5。
Most wedding rings are 3.5 grams.
而且那个是一个24K 的。
And that was a 24-karat gold ring.
所以隔了几天呢，他又回来找我。
And after a couple of days, he came back to look for me.
他拿出两个戒指来。
He took out two rings.
他说：“我用你的戒指买了两个戒指。”
I used your ring to buy two rings.
他说：“我跟那个人说呢，就把这个戒指的重量分成两个戒指。”
He said, "Just take that ring, take the weight of that ring, and divide that into two rings."
然后下一次我们在一起祷告的时候呢，他的未婚妻呢就流泪说上帝如何的供应他们的需要。
And the next time we have prayer meeting, his fiance with tears in her eyes just thanking God for providing for their needs.
但是因为我没有跟我妈讲说我把这个戒指送人了。
But I never told my mom I'd given that ring.
所以呢，我常常就 consciously 我就把手这样挡。放着我的那个盖住我戴戒指的手。
So, because I never told my mom, so a lot of times in front of my mom, I'll consciously or unconsciously cover my hand.
但是呢，久了以后呢，我也忘记了。
And so long time, after a while, I forgot.
然后有一天呢，他就突然看到了。
And so one day my mom noticed.
她说你的戒指去哪里了？
My mom said, where is your ring?
我不想说谎。
I did not want to lie.
她说其实我把这个戒指送人了。
I said, well, really, I gave that ring away.
她说我的一个好朋友，他结婚没有钱买戒指，他用我的戒指买了两个戒指。
I said, one of my friends wants to get married. He did not have money. So I gave him my ring, and with that ring, he was able to get two rings.
我妈的回答让我非常的惊讶。
And my mom's answer shocked me.
她说，你怎么不把金链子也送给她？
My mom said, why didn't you give them the gold chain as well?
我跟我妈说，妈，我没那么慷慨。
I said to my mom, "Mom, I am not that generous."
感谢主，我们不是一个很富裕的家庭。
Thank the Lord, we're not a wealthy family.
但是我从我父母学到了什么是慷慨。
But I learned from my mom and dad what it means to be generous.
什么是 charity?
What is charity?
其实钱它可以是一个偶像，但是钱它也可以做很多的好事情。
You see, money can become an idol, but we can do a lot of good with money.
下一章。最近呢，纽约的 Redeemer Presbyterian Church， 就是 Tim Keller 的教会呢，他做了一个 buck the trend 的事情。
Recently, Redeemer Presbyterian Church did this amazing thing.
通常现在呢，你会常常听到呢。很多的教会因为没有会友了，所以呢，教会变成酒吧，教会变成餐厅，教会变成 condo。
You know, you have heard pretty often today because of less people attending church. Oftentimes, you hear that a church turned into a bar, a church turned into a condo, or a church turned into a theater.
但是 Tim Keller 这个教会呢，他们呢？这里我是看一个新闻的题目 headline， 他说这个 Redeemer Church redeems a condo。
But what Tim Keller's Redeemer Presbyterian Church has done is something else. And I saw a news headline that says Redeemer Presbyterian Church redeemed a condo。
他们花了$3,000,000买了这一栋楼。
They spent $30 million and bought this building。
他们要准备把这个 condo 改成教会。
They're renovating this condo into a church.
所以当很多的教会变成酒吧、变成餐厅的时候 ，Tim Keller 他 buck the trend， 他用这个钱把 condo 变成教会。
So when the time when a lot of churches are becoming bars and restaurants, Tim Keller bucked the trend and they're going to change this condo into a church.
所以最后一章我用一个图画做结束。
And last of all, I just want to conclude with this.
因为这篇，因为这段经文，我们会在路加福音讲到。
Because this picture, we will be more clear as we preach the Gospel of Luke.
因为在那个少年官忧忧愁愁的离开之后呢，耶稣说了一句话。
Because after that rich young ruler left Jesus, Jesus says this word.
他说若财主进天国比穿过针眼更难。
It's easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich person to enter the kingdom of God.
所以这张图呢是一个穿过针眼的骆驼。
So here you see it's a camel who has gone through the eye of a needle.
然后呢希望我们每一个人不管你有多少钱我们都可以学习成为一个穿过针眼的骆驼。
So here in the story, no matter how much resource you have, may you be like the camel that has passed through the eye of the needle.
因为我们看到美国的例子 ，Idaho 是给最慷慨的一个州。
Because we see in America, the most generous state is actually Idaho.
然后在哥林多后书，保罗夸奖的是一个非常贫穷的马其顿教会。
In the church that Apostle Paul prays in 2 Corinthians is a very poor church.
所以不是我们有多少，而是我们给了多少。
It's not how much money we have, it's how much we have actually given.
Jeff Bezos 的1250万或许在世人眼中看起来非常的多。
The 125 million from Jeff Bezos is a lot of money.
但是在上帝的天平上，它只值87块。
But in God's eyes, he's basically given $85.
当我们写一张 check 要奉献。要捐给某一个机构的时候，我们常常会挣扎的。
A lot of times when we're writing a check to give to an organization, we struggle.
特别是我们想要给很多的时候。
Especially when we want to give a lot.
所以呢，我们在这个月，当我们讲到钱的时候呢，让我们每一个人都学习操练，让我们可以成为一个穿过针眼的骆驼。
So you know, as we are talking about finance this month.May all of us be like that camel who's able to go through the eye of the needle.
我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray.
亲爱的天父，求你帮助我们，让我们能可以像 Idaho 的基督徒，可以像马其顿教会的基督徒一样。
Father, we just come before you, Lord, and earnestly ask you that you would help us, Lord, as Christians, to be like the example of the Macedonian Christians.
我们知道，当我们钱财越多的时候，我们真的变得比较难以慷慨。
Lord, we know, Lord, the more money we have, the harder it is to be charitable.
因为我们的倾向是喜爱金钱。
Because, Lord, in our natural selves, we love our money and finance.
但是你也借着保罗提醒我们，喜爱金钱是万恶之根。
And Father, and thank you for the warning you give us to Apostle Paul that the love of money is a sign of the last days.
所以求你帮助我们，让我们学习做一个有恩慈的人，让我们学习做一个慷慨的人。
So Father, help us to be one who has grace and one who is charitable.
让我们知道，我们甚至可以借着金钱，我们可以跟很多的弟兄姐妹建立美好的团契关系。
And so, Lord, help us to see money as a means that we can establish good fellowship with many brothers and sisters.
钱可以成为我们的偶像。
Money can become our idol.
但是，当我们如果穿过针眼，钱也可以成为一个有用的。有用的工具来帮助很多人。
Father, we know that money, Lord, is an idol for many of us. But Lord, through your grace, Lord, we know that money can also become a tool for building up your kingdom.
我们这样祷告，奉主耶稣的圣名祈求。
We pray these things in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. 好，我们有几件事情报告。
We just have a couple announcements.
首先我们还是要欢迎在线上聚会以及我们好像很久没有欢迎新朋友了。
we want to welcome those of us who are worshiping with us in person right here. And we haven't had a chance to welcome new friends for a while.
在这段期间其实有一些新朋友都已经变成旧朋友了。
And you know, during this time when we've been live streaming, a lot of new friends have become old friends already, and we don't even know.
对，像中文堂有一对夫妇小龙跟王雪，他们已经来了好几个月了。
For example, in the Chinese congregation, we have had a couple, 小龙 and
王雪。
Been coming for a couple months.
但是我们从来没有正式欢迎过他们。
We have never officially welcomed you.
还有前一阵子来了一对异国就是先生是美国人，从夏威夷搬来的。
And before that there was a couple as well, and where the husband's from Hawaii.
所以太太是从夏威夷来，
yeah.
对不起。
Okay, I'm sorry. The husband's American, the wife is from Hawaii.
像还有Elaine 跟 Jeff 的小女孩 Anna 也已经好几个月大了。
Yeah, and Jeff and Elaine's Anna, a couple months old now.
所以我们也从来没有正式的欢迎。
And we never really officially welcome you.
啊，我们所以呢，这次我们要正式的欢迎沙雪跟 Todd， 他们终于等待到他们的男孩。
Oh, excellent. We also want to thank God for Todd and Carol or Sasha. They actually had a baby boy.
所以呢，在这段疫情期间，我们虽然没有彼此见面，但是我们真的是在祷告中彼此纪念，我们真的是恭喜欢迎每一位人。
So even though we can't be with you, we want to welcome you and be in person. We want to welcome you and remember you and praise you on our behalf on prayers.
阿东，你有报告事项的没有 ？Do you have? 好，那另外就是如果各查经班，各位如果在这段期间，你们决定用网络上的任何一个工具，你们可以跟教会的敬牧师来申请这个费用。
So also just as an important announcement for many of you, when you've been using online platform, in online platform in order to have your Bible study such as Zoom, you can actually get reimbursed through the church if you like.
好，那我们就请起立，我们一起来唱。
Let's all rise.
赞美真神万福之根，世上万民赞美主恩，天使天君赞美主名。赞美圣父圣子圣灵，阿们。愿主耶稣基督的恩惠，天父上帝的慈爱，圣灵宝惠师的交通与感动，帮助我们做一个恩慈慷慨的人，从今时到永远。
May the grace of our Lord Jesus and the love of God the Father and the fellowship of Holy Spirit bless us so that we can be the charitable and generous person that God wants us to be from now on and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated. Service is over today. Thank you for joining us. 谢谢。